It's the start of a long, cold, grey day for Russian strategic rocket forces personnel. Here, a Soviet-era MAZ-537 heavy equipment transporter is pulling a 10-wheeled semi-trailer carrying a missile transport launching container. Inside, we are told by Russian officials, is an adapted UR-100N intercontinental ballistic missile. The missile system is being delivered to the Russian 13th Orenburg Red Banner Rocket Division, located near the closed city of Yazny, Komarovsky, Orenburg Oblast. A complex array of support vehicles and troops will spend more than 5 hours installing the transport launching container and its enclosed missile into its specifically designed UR-100 silo. However, it turns out this is no ordinary missile system. Russia sent shockwaves around the world when in March 2018, President Putin unveiled the existence to the world of its strategic Avangard Hypersonic Glide Vehicle, or HGV. Russia's top secret Avangard HGV is, he revealed, fielded on a UR-100N intercontinental ballistic missile and designed to evade the latest US anti ballistic missile defences. According to the Russian Ministry of Defense, the UR-100N intercontinental ballistic missile booster encapsulated inside this transport launching container is actually fitted with Russia's top secret Avangard hypersonic glide vehicle. The Avangard HGV is housed in the payload nose fairing of the missile, most often referred to as the missile cone. This combination of the Soviet-era 100N intercontinental ballistic missile, now updated to the more powerful 126-ton 27.5-meter-long UR-100NUTTKH, plus its Avangard HGV, is designated in Russia as RS-18A. It has now become to be known to US intelligence sources as the SS-19 Stiletto Mod 4. In December 2018, Russia test-fired the weapon from this very site, the Domborossky missile base in Orenburg Oblast. The SS-19 Stiletto ICBM boosted the Avangard HGV more than 6,000 kilometers before striking a target in the Kura shooting range in Kamchatka Peninsula in the Russian Far East. This is the actual footage from that launch. So how does the Avangard HGV work, and why should the West be seriously worried by this weapon? So basically, the SS-19 Stiletto ICBM houses the Avangard HGV in the nose fairing or cone. It is launched to its suborbital apogee of around 100 kilometers above sea level. The payload nose fairing will detach, now becoming the space launch vehicle for the Avangard hypersonic glide vehicle. The space launch vehicle itself will then open and release the Avangard HGV. It then cruises down towards its target through the atmosphere, delivering a nuclear blast yield of between 0.8 to 2 megatons. It's worth noting the little boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima, Japan, was 0.015 megatons, or 15 kilotons, of TNT. The world stunned at the time, seeing the pictures of devastation from a single bomb blast on a large city, delivered and dropped by a B-29 Superfortress. Couldn't, nearly 80 years later, have imagined the complexity of a nuclear weapon delivery system such as the Vanguard HGV. In his March 2018 speech, Vladimir Putin claimed that HGV can maintain atmospheric speeds of up to Mach 20 and can actually manoeuvre. The Vanguard HGV likely does not employ a propulsion system, relying on gravity and its aerodynamic features maintain speeds and altitude. It could be fitted with internal stowed stabilizing tail fins, wings or canards, which can be deployed after launch to give greater glider control. The Avangard maneuverability could make Avangard's trajectory unpredictable, complicating intercept attempts, especially by US anti ballistic missile defences after its boost phase. Even more worrying for Western nations, the Avangard HGV could, in the future, be launched by the massive 208 tons, 35.5 metres long RS-28 Sarmat Super Heavy Intercontinental Ballistic Missile, unofficially called Satan 2. It's reported by the Russian military its payload system could carry 4 Avangard hypersonic glide vehicles. I will leave you with a video clip of a successful launch of an RS-28 Sarmat ICBM, recorded April 2022. The missile is now in service in 2023.